Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 3rd of July. Indian Prime Minister Modi takes veiled dig at China, says age of expansionism over. India slams Pakistan's absurd comments on Karachi attack. Pentagon says Taliban still maintains ties with Al-Qaeda. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday said the age of expansionism is over as he paid tribute to soldiers killed in last month's border skirmish with China on a surprise visit to the northern Himalayan region of Ladakh amid escalating tension between the Asian giants.
India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi flew into the northern Himalayan region of Ladakh on Friday, accompanied by top army officials, weeks after Indian and Chinese troops clashed on their disputed border there, escalating tensions between the Asian giants. Modi, who has been under pressure to respond to what India deems Chinese incursions, met troops at a base in Ladakh's Nimu area. Both India and China have traded blame for triggering the high-altitude brawl in the Galwan Valley on June 15, in which 20 Indian soldiers were killed. China has not disclosed how many casualties its troops suffered. While addressing the soldiers, Modi said that the era of expansionism is over and history is proof that expansionists have either lost or were forced to turn back.
विस्तारवाद की जीत जब किसी पर सवार हो हुई है उसने हमेशा विश्व शांति के सामने खतरा पैदा किया और साथियों ये न भूले इतिहास गवाह है कि ऐसी ताकतें मिट गई हैं या
Since the violent standoff, the nuclear-armed neighbors have amassed troops along the border, most of which remains disputed, and military and diplomatic talks are going on to de-escalate the confrontation. While reacting to the Indian Prime Minister's Ladakh visit, Chinese Foreign Ministry said that no party should engage in any action that may escalate the situation at this point.
The Indian Council of Medical Research has directed clinical trial sites of Covaxin to fast-track approvals, saying that the experimental coronavirus vaccine was the top priority project of the government.
The Indian Council of Medical Research or ICMR Director General Dr. Balram Bhargav has written a letter to Bharat Biotech and principal investigators of medical colleges to complete the trial procedure of indigenous COVID-19 vaccine in a fast-track method so that results of a clinical trial can be launched by August 15. A total of 12 institutes have been asked by the ICMR to fast-track clinical trials of the vaccine. However, ICMR clarified that the purpose of the letter was to expedite trials so that results could be available by August 15. The vaccine would need more time for public use. Meanwhile, ICMR on Friday informed that 9,297,749 COVID-19 tests were conducted by various laboratories across the country till July 2. This comes as India reported the highest ever single-day spike of 20,903 COVID-19 cases in 24 hours on Friday. With these new cases, India's coronavirus tally has risen to 625,544, of which 227,439 patients are active cases.
India on Thursday rejected Pakistan's allegation that the June 29 terrorist attack on Karachi Stock Exchange was instigated by New Delhi as absurd and chided Islamabad for attempting to shift the blame for its own domestic problems.
India's foreign ministry on Thursday rejected absurd comments by Pakistan, accusing India of instigating attacks on Pakistan's stock exchange building in Karachi earlier this week. Indian Foreign Ministry spokesperson Anurag Srivastava in a weekly press briefing said, Islamabad cannot shift the blame on New Delhi for its domestic problems. He rather urged that Pakistan should reflect on the problems in their own country as well as the government led by Prime Minister Imran Khan, who had himself called global terrorist Osama bin Laden a martyr while addressing the National Assembly.
India rejects these absurd comments on the terrorist attack in Karachi, and Pakistan cannot shift the blame on India for its domestic problems. We would ask Pakistan that they may wish to reflect on this and on their own government's position, including their Prime Minister's description of the global terrorist as a martyr.
Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan told Parliament on Tuesday he had no doubt that India was behind the attack, but he had no evidence to back up his claim. The Pakistan Stock Exchange building came under attack on Monday as four gunmen tried to storm into the building, killing two guards and a policeman, before security forces killed the attackers. The Balochistan Liberation Army or BLA, a separatist insurgent group from the southwestern province of Balochistan, claimed responsibility for the attack.
Moving on, Pakistan's Sindh province government on Thursday extended the custody of Al-Qaeda leader Ahmed Omar Saeed Sheikh and his three aides until 30th of September in the 2002 gruesome killing of American journalist Daniel Pearl. 38-year-old Pearl was beheaded in Pakistan while investigating a story on the alleged links between the country's powerful spy agency ISI and Al-Qaeda.
The government of Pakistan's Sindh province on Thursday extended for another 3 months the custody of British-born Al-Qaeda leader Ahmed Omar Saeed Sheikh and his three aides, whose sentences in the abduction and murder of U.S. journalist Daniel Pearl in 2002 were overturned in April. 38-year-old Pearl was South Asia bureau chief for the Wall Street Journal when he was abducted and beheaded in Pakistan while investigating a story in 2002 on the alleged links between the country's powerful spy agency ISI and Al-Qaeda. The move comes days after the Supreme Court on June 29 rejected a petition filed by the Sindh government to suspend a high court verdict that overturned the conviction of the four men. The court, however, allowed the province to take measures to keep them in custody. Their detention expired on July 1, local media reports said. The Sindh government extended their custody for another 90 days until September 30.
Pakistani nurse Unzala Uram puts on her personal protective equipment or PPE as she prepares for her shift in the COVID-19 emergency ward at Indus Hospital in Karachi. But it is not just her experience as a nurse that puts her at good stead with the patients, but the fact that she herself had caught the virus and recovered from it. Unzala began working in the coronavirus ward after hospital officials started the facility following the first case to emerge in Karachi in February. Despite strict precautions and protective gear, Unzala tested positive for the coronavirus. While in isolation, Unzala said she kept in touch with her family by phone. But at her hospital, patients in the emergency ward are not allowed to have family members visit or cell phones.
Whenever I rejoin my work, मैं उनका ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा इस चीज़ का ख्याल रखूँगी कि किसी ना किसी तरीके से उनको कॉन्टैक्ट किया जाए या मेरे थ्रू ही मैं उनका मैसेज उनके फैमिली मेम्बर्स को कन्वे कर सकूँ.
Colleagues say they too have noticed the difference in the way Unzala and other staff who have recovered from COVID-19 now interact with patients. Meanwhile, the total cases in Pakistan reached 221,896 on Friday, with the death toll at 4,551.
A Pentagon report released this week has revealed that the Taliban still maintains relations with the Al-Qaeda despite promising to cut ties with the terror group under US-Taliban agreement signed in February.
The Taliban maintains relations with Al-Qaeda despite promising to cut ties with the terror group under US-Taliban agreement signed earlier this year, the Pentagon has said in a report. According to the congressionally mandated report released this week, the Al-Qaeda in the Indian subcontinent, or AQIS, routinely supports and works with low-level Taliban members in its efforts to undermine the Afghan government and maintains an enduring interest in attacking US forces and Western targets in the region. It also states that since the Trump administration's signing of the US-Taliban agreement in February, the Taliban increased violence levels above historical norms, targeting Afghan military and police convoys and outposts while refraining from attacking major cities or US and coalition personnel. In February, Washington had pledged to cut down US troop levels in Afghanistan to 8,600 by mid-July, a reduction that has already been achieved. In return, the Taliban promised to cut ties with Al-Qaeda and enter into intra-Afghan negotiations with the Afghan government.
Nepal's Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli this week recommended prorogation of the ongoing session of the federal parliament after finding himself on shaky ground in the wake of growing calls from within his party to step down. Amid rift in party, co-chair of ruling Nepal Communist Party, Pushpa Kamal Dahal, has claimed that the party's future is uncertain due to internal factions after Thursday's political upheaval.
Co-chair of ruling Nepal Communist Party, or NCP, Pushpa Kamal Dahal, has claimed that the party's future is uncertain due to internal factions after Thursday's political upheaval. Dahal made the statement during the second round of the standing committee meeting on Thursday after having a separate meeting with President Vidya Devi Bhandari and Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli. Oli had got both houses of parliament prorogued without consulting their presiding officer to ward off threats to his continuance in office. Dahal in the recent standing committee meetings had demanded the resignation of the Prime Minister for mishandling the pandemic and making unilateral decisions without consulting the leaders. Despite the ongoing rift in the ruling party, Dahal claimed that he is committed to protecting the unity of the party. Dahal and Oli share the chairmanship of the ruling Nepal Communist Party after the merger of the party, after its coalition worked in 2017 general election in which it swept the results, securing a majority. Since the unification between the two parties, the factions had increased inside the NCP, forming alliance of former Prime Minister Madhav Kumar Nepal, Dahal and Oli. Meanwhile, the next standing committee meeting of the ruling party has been called on for Saturday as Dahal asked for a day's time to forge consensus with Prime Minister Oli.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. Indian Prime Minister Modi takes veiled dig at China, says age of expansionism over. India slams Pakistan's absurd comments on Karachi attack. And Pentagon says Taliban still maintains ties with Al-Qaeda. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at SAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.